Hello, amiguitos. Good afternoon. Buenas tardes. Ooh, I look so bright. Look so good. Did you have a good lunch? Yes. Did you finish your homework? I hope so. Well, here's a little song. Yes, I see that. Hello. All right. Well, you know, today's such a beautiful day. I mean, the sky is blue. The clouds are nice and fluffy like this. And the sun is out. But you know, that's not why it's a beautiful day. It's a beautiful day because today we celebrate you. Este día es tan hermoso. Olvida tus penas y preocupaciones, que este día es tan hermoso. Es día de los niños, es día de los libros. And now I'm going to sing it in English for those of you that didn't understand. Today's such a beautiful day. Forget your worries and forget your troubles, because today's such a beautiful day. Es día de los niños, es día de los libros. Con ustedes, ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, the darling of our show, Miss Vicky. Say hello, Miss Vicky.
Hi, everybody. It's good to see you guys.
And now, I leave you with Miss Connie, a.k.a. Miss Conchita.
Hi, everyone. Hola, buenas tardes.
I'll be a little bit more comfortable here.
¿Cómo están todos? Gracias por venir y visitarnos en nuestra celebración del Día de los Niños. Y primero quiero decirle que por favor nos den un fuerte aplauso. Ahí no los escucho. Un fuerte aplauso for the grant that we received from the California State Library. It's actually part of the Early Learning and Families Project Grant. Okay, y esto es posible por ellos. So, muchos aplausos para ellos porque tenemos tantas cosas para ustedes hoy. So, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to read you guys a story. Sí, una historia. Y esta historia se llama Viva Frida, porque hoy estamos celebrando el Día de los Niños y es un día con Frida, a day with Frida. Viva Frida, por Yuyi Morales, by Yuyi Morales. Soy.
I am.
Yo.
I.
Busco.
Search. ¿Qué busca Frida? What is Frida looking for?
Veo.
I see.
¿Qué mira Frida?
What is she looking at?
Yo también lo veo. ¿Ustedes lo ven?
Wow.
¿Qué tendrá dentro?
What is inside?
Ajá. Ajá. ¿Qué encontró?
What did she find?
Juego, I play. Mira que se encontró.
What is that?
Can anybody tell me? ¿Qué es eso? Anybody know what that is? ¿Alguien sabe qué es eso? Yo escuché a alguien decirlo. Un títere, a puppet. Good job.
Sé.
I know. Sueño.
I dream.
¿Ustedes sueñan? Yo sueño todo el tiempo. Y me doy cuenta, and I realize, qué bonito vestido tiene. De que, that. ¿Qué encontró ahí? Qué bonito. Siento.
I feel.
Ay, yo también lo siento. Y entiendo.
And I understand.
Que amo.
That I love.
¡Mua! Te da un besote. Y creo arte.
And create.
Y por lo tanto, and so. Wow, qué bonita pintura. ¿De quién? Sí, de Frida.
Vivo.
I live. Y colorín colorado, este cuento se ha acabado. The end. Ahora, I would like to introduce you to our next person, Miss Vicky. Pero, before she goes, you guys are going to follow along. Ustedes tienen su libro, you guys have your book. So, it's in the kit. It's per family that you guys received the book. So, here it goes. Yes, so follow along. Síganos, por favor.
Hi, everybody. It's good to see you guys. Are you guys excited for the story? It's a beautiful, beautiful story. I'm going to take this off. And like Miss Connie said, if you guys got our kit, please follow along with us. And it is called Frida and Her Animalitos by Monica Brown. And the beautiful illustrations are done by John Parra. So I hope you guys are ready because I am. Now, before I read this, do any of you have some animalitos at home? Maybe a cat, maybe a dog, a lizard, a parrot. What else? Maybe a turkey? Oh, let's see. Okay. Frida and her animalitos. Oh, somebody said I have two dogs. I have a dog too, and two cats, and some birds. This is a story of a little girl named Frida, who grew up to be one of the most famous painters of all time. Frida was special, like all of you. This is also the story of two monkeys, a parrot, three dogs, two turkeys, an eagle, a black cat, and a fawn. Whew. Those are a lot of animalitos. They were Frida's pets and they were special too. Frida had a parrot named Bonito. Bonito, ¿estás aquí?
Bonito,
there's Bonito.
Mira qué bonitas feathers. Qué colores tan hermosos. Gracias, Bonito.
Frida.
She liked to wear bold shades to celebrate her indigenous Mexico and her heritage. She lived in a bright blue house called La Casa Azul, where she grew up with her mom, her dad, and her two sisters. Ahí está, mira, qué bonita casa. What bright blue it was. Frida also had a pet fawn named Granizo. Granizo, ¿estás aquí? Granizo, mira, está Granizo. Hola, Granizo, ¿cómo estás ahora? Dile hola a todos los niños que están allí. Gracias, Granizo. And like her fawn, Frida had watchful, beautiful eyes. And when Frida closed her eyes,
she remembered her life as a little girl. Frida was always with her father, who was a photographer, and he taught her how to look at the world through curious eyes. Frida and her father would walk to the park to collect bugs to look under a microscope. Oh, I think I hear some bugs. Oh, no. We're doing a story time, you guys. We're doing story time. Frida's father also taught her how to paint finishing touches on his photographs. Frida loved the small brushes and beautiful colors. Frida had a cat with black, shiny fur, the same color as her long, dark hair. Gatito! There she is. Mira que bonito fur, how shiny. Say hi to all the kids. Yeah. Thank you for coming. Que bonito gatito. Like her cat, Frida was playful, but as a child, Frida couldn't always play. When Frida was six, she got very, very sick, and she was in bed for a very long time. But little Frida didn't get sad or bored. Oh no. Instead, she used her breath to make a mist on the window, and there she drew a door with her finger. Frida used her big imagination and curious eyes to walk through the door with a magical friend, a little girl who danced and played just like her kitten. Frida was very independent, just like her cat. Frida's sickness left her with one leg different from the other, and children sometimes made fun of her, which is not nice. But this didn't stop her. Didn't stop Frida from skating and riding bikes and rowing on lakes in Chapultepec Park so that her leg could get stronger. Frida was not afraid to do things other little girls didn't usually do. She wore overalls and boxed and wrestled. She had a lot of fun. Look, she's on her bike. Do you guys like riding bikes? Do you guys like roller skating? I'm gonna tell you a secret. Don't tell anybody. I don't know how to ride a bike. Shh. It's okay. Frida also, get this, she had two spider monkeys, Fulong Tang and Camito de Guayabat. Oh, I think I hear them. Or are they here? Oh, I hear them. There they are. They're being a little mischievous. Are you guys here to listen to story time? Yes? Okay, go sit down though. Go sit down. Frida could be mischievous too, even when she was a teenager. When Frida was 15, she went to school called La Preparatoria and found a group of friends that she loved. Like Frida, her friends were curious to learn all they could. Together, they read and studied and argued and sometimes got in trouble. Wearing matching caps, they rode donkeys through the halls of the preparatoria and set off firecrackers. I bet you they got in a lot of trouble for that. And look, there's her little monkeys. And there she is. Frida also had an eagle named Gertrudis. Gertrudis, are you here? There she is, look it. Like her eagle, Frida's imagination could fly really, really. Can you fly really high, Gertrudis? Oh, thank you. When Frida was 18, she was in a terrible accident. And once again, she had to be in bed for many, many months. This time, Frida didn't create a magical friend. She created art. Frida's mother made her a special easel and hung it a mirror over her canopy bed so Frida could paint. Frida used her imagination and curious eyes to do just that. Feet, what do I need them for when I have wings to fly? And if those weren't enough pets, Frida also had two turkeys. Oh, do I hear them? Look, they came to visit us. Can you guys all say hi?
Okay, we gotta finish.
Frida's turkeys were intelligent and sensitive, just like herself. But like I said, those weren't her only animals. She also had a few dogs. The first one was called Señor Cholo. Señor Cholo. Señor Cholo, where? Señor Cholo. Oh, what's up? How are you doing? Okay. The next one was called Señorita Capulina. Señorita.
Ay, mira que bella, que dama. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
¿Puedes decirle hola a todos los niños? And lastly was Señora Costi. Señora Costi. Señora Costi, ¿cómo estás?
Mira, ahí está. Oh, qué diva, pues. Okay, I see you. Okay.
Her dogs were Cholo dogs. They were the same breed that ran and hunted with the Aztecs thousands of years ago, and a reflection of Frida's heritage, of which she was very, very proud. Frida's dogs had no hair, but their bodies were warm, and Frida gave them great big hugs whenever she felt lonely or sad. Frida's animalitos were spirited and entertaining, just like Frida. When her two spider monkeys were being good, Frida would hold them just like babies. But when they were being mischievous, they would steal socks and fruit and leap through windows so no one could catch them. Oh, oh, there!
Are you guys back?
I think they're being naughty.
You guys are being, oh, sit down. You're interrupting the story time.
Okay. Her parrot named Bonito liked to snuggle under the covers with Frida when she took naps. And he would do tricks at dinner for pats of butter. Oh, I think I hear him. I think I hear him. Oh,
hola, Bonito. Pretty bird.
Oh, you are a pretty bird.
Pretty bird.
I don't have any butter. I'm sorry.
Frida.
I don't have any butter. Go sit. Frida's animalitos played all day in the courtyard at La Casa Azul, the bright blue house on Londres Street. Her husband, Diego Rivera, even made the animals a pyramid to climb, so they could roam freely all day. And look, let's see, can you guys find the fawn? You guys see it? There he is. And how about the cat? Oh, he's kind of hiding. Do you guys see the pretty cat?
Here.
When Frida painted, her pets would keep her company, and Frida painted all the time. While the birds sang, the dogs barked, and the turkeys danced in the garden. Frida's animals were her children, her friends, and her inspiration. Okay, what a beautiful picture. Frida painted when she was sick and hurting, and Frida painted when she was happy. She also painted when Diego was gone and she was sad. But Frida was never alone in the Casa Azul, the bright blue house on Londres Street. She had her animalitos and herself, and she painted both. Frida painted herself with Fulang Chang, playing with ribbons. Oh, oh, there he is. Look at you, playing with ribbons. She painted herself with Bonito the parrot. Bonito, are you back?
Pretty bird.
Oh, there he is.
Pretty bird.
And she painted herself with the black cat peeking over her shoulder. Where's, so I think I hear.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is.
Yeah.
And there he is too. Frida painted herself with all of her pets she loves so much. And even the butterflies, caterpillars, her paintings were magical. And today, if you visit La Casa Azul in Coyoacán, just outside of Mexico City, you might hear the sound of a bird.
Pretty bird, pretty bird.
Did you guys hear it? Did you guys hear it?
Pretty.
Is that bonito? Or you might see a black cat jump from the pyramid that sits in the courtyard. Do you guys hear?
Yeah.
You, so you might hear him at the bright blue house on Londa Street where Frida and her animalitos lived so many years ago. And just so you guys can see, okay, there's Frida with one of her pretty cholo dogs. Isn't that beautiful? Well, I hope you enjoyed that story. And now we're going to have Miss Connie do a felt story time with you. So I hope you enjoyed it. Please give a big hand to Miss Connie.
Hola.
Ahora tenemos una actividad. We have an activity. Y a ver si se la saben. Esta es bien fácil. Se llama Querida Frida, Querida Frida. Dear Frida, Dear Frida in English. Okay. So this is how it goes. It goes, Querida Frida, Querida Frida, are you in the blank house? Or are you in la blank casita? Because remember, casita is house in English. So, you guys ready? Pero primero quiero saber, you guys know your colors? ¿Ustedes saben sus colores? ¿Sí? A ver si es cierto. Let's see if it's true. So, tenemos aquí una, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis casitas. Six houses? You guys know all these colors? Are you sure? Vamos a ver. Porque se acuerdan, Frida tuvo una casita y estaba plano. It was flat house. It wasn't like our regular houses, right? So tenemos, ¿qué color es este? ¿Se lo saben? Yo oí a alguien que lo dijo. Sí, verde. Green. Good job. ¿Y este? Do you guys know si se lo saben? Sí, yo lo escuché a otra persona decirlo. Rojo, red. Good job. ¿Y este? Sí saben. Amarillo. Yellow. Good job. And that one? Sí, anaranjado, orange. You guys are great. ¿Y este? Sí. Oh my goodness, everyone's so intelligent. Azul, blue. ¿Y este? El último color, sí se lo saben, ¿verdad? Sí, morado, purple. Good job, guys. Oh, you guys are so great. So vamos a usar esos colores. Again, you can say it in English or in Spanish. In English, it would be, dear Frida, are you in the blank house? O en español, lo pueden decir, querida Frida, estás en la color de la casa. Vamos a ver, ¿listos? So, Frida here is who we're going to look for en una de esas casas. So, se va a esconder, entonces she's going to hide. So, cuando se esconde una persona, ¿qué vamos a hacer nosotros? Sí, vamos a cerrar los ojos. You can do this too. No peeking, okay? No vayan a ver. Ready? Pero vamos a cantar, a contar del 1 al 10. We're going to count 1 through 10. And then we're going to look for Frida. Remember the little two. Ready? So, we're going to put our fingers over our eyes, and we're gonna count to 10. ¿Listos? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Ready or not? Here we come. ¿Y dónde está Frida? Let's see. Vamos a ver. Yo y alguien. Me dijeron verde. Let's see. Querida Frida. Are you in the casa verde? Let's see. No está ahí. Pero ¿quién será hasta ahí? Es un changuito. Ese no es Frida. Oh, ahí que dijeron rojo. Vamos a hacer esa. Vamos a hacerlo en inglés. Ready? Dear Frida, are you in the red house? Ahí no está Frida.
¡Ah! ¡Es un Sherlock dog! ¡Ah! ¡Un perro Sherlock! ¡Ah! ¡Hola!
Yo oí amarillo. Oh my goodness. Okay, remember. You know how it goes. You can do it in English or Spanish. Querida Frida, querida Frida. Are you in the yellow house? Ah, no está nadie ahí. Alguien dijo anaranjado. Okay, orange. Okay, we'll do orange. Querida Frida, querida Frida. Are you in the orange house? No. ¿Qué es eso? Ah, es un loro. Sí, bonito loro. Dijeron morado. Ok, sí, vamos a ser morado. Querida Frida, querida Frida. Are you in the purple house? Vamos a ver. No, no está ahí. ¿Sí? Oh, ahorita vamos al azul. ¿Quién es? Perdón, no sé si lo pueden ver. Es el fan, el venadito. Vamos a ser el último. Los quiero ir todos. Remember, English or Spanish. Up to you guys. Ready? Querida Frida, querida Frida. Are you in the blue house? ¿Quién dice que está ahí? ¿Ustedes creen? Ay, vamos a ver. Sí, porque su casa es azul. Ay, sí. Y miren qué bonita. Ay, qué bonita Frida. Muy buena. ¿Y qué tiene ahí? Vamos a ver qué tiene. Tiene unos aretes. Some earrings. They're very beautiful. Tiene su collar. She has her necklace. What else does she have? ¿Me pueden decir ustedes? Ah, sí. Claro que sí. Yes, her changuito, her mono. Her monkey. ¿Qué más tiene? Tal vez ven unos diferentes colores. What colors do you see? Sí. Flores en la cabeza. Flowers in her head. That's so awesome. You guys are great. ¿Qué más notan? What else do you notice? Her saco. Yes, good job. O su shawl. Tal vez será un shawl or un suéter. Up to you, whatever you guys would see. Let me see, what else do you guys see? Sí, los labios rojos. Ah, buena observación. Okay, so ahora vamos a decir bye, Frida. Y vamos a tener a Josué.
¿Cómo están, amiguitos? How are you? Good? Okay. Well, con ustedes. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, niñas y niños, gatos y perros. Frida, the one and only Frida Kahlo. Say hello, Frida. Say hello, kids. That's Frida. Wow. Wait a minute. There's two Fridas? On this side, we have a Frida with roses on her hair. Wow, and look at her lips. Oh, te dio un beso. Oh, otro. Oh, te dio otro beso. Le voy a decir a tu mamá, ¿eh? Vas a ver. And on the other side, we see the other Frida, la otra Frida. This Frida has pink lips y también le gusta dar besos. Wow, te dio otro beso. Wow, dos besos. ¿Cuál besa mejor? Pues fíjate, las dos Fridas son la misma Frida. Both Fridas are the same Frida. She actually had a painting named Las Dos Fridas. Ella tenía una pintura, una obra de arte que se llamaba Las Dos Fridas. Una y dos. Oh, esta Frida dice que quiere hacer una artesanía. And this Frida says she wants to make a craft. Oh, for the kids. Para los adultos. Una artesanía para toda la familia. Wow. They both said they want to make arts and crafts with the whole family. With Miss Vicky and Miss Connie. Oh, well, without further ado, here are Miss Vicky and Miss Connie talking about the craft that we're making for this special program. Adios.
Again.
Hola.
So as you know, when hopefully you guys got your kit and it was in a bag like this, right, Queen?
Mm-hmm. Everybody should have gotten their kit. And tenemos ahí las artesanías that we have all of our crafts there.
In the kit.
Yeah.
What's this?
We have paper plates.
And we have
platos de papel. Y imprimación de la carita de quién? De Frida. Sí.
Oh.
Y lo pueden hacer así como ustedes gusten. Mm-hmm.
Then,
y tenemos un marcapágina que ustedes pueden hacer si lo pueden ver. Oh, son partes de una muñequita para que puedan hacer a Frida. Frida.
Ustedes le pintan la cara.
Mm-hmm.
También. A lo mejor para los adultos o para los teens o para quien quiera, se ven unos tiles así.
Pero son para hacer coasters para sus bebidas, para que no se vaya a mojar tanto la mesa, ¿verdad? Lo pueden decorar como ustedes gusten. You guys can decorate however you like.
You guys got stickers, you guys got this page here, mm-hmm. And you can use whatever you like. We made these. Let me see it. Backwards, but you guys can use them and make them however you want.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Y todo está bueno. Uno más.
Some of you got cards like this, and some of you got cards like this.
Mm-hmm.
And those are to make cartas para la familia, para tus amigos, para el perro, para el gato, para el loro, para el fawn, para los bugs, whoever you guys want to make cards.
A quien le quieran mandar.
And you can use all of the extra stuff. This is the one I made. Because you guys got a coloring sheet, darán una página de colorear. Pueden hacer una así o como ustedes gusten.
Y por favor, sean creativos, porque como Frida, ella fue bien creativa, ¿verdad? She was very creative.
Unos colores.
Mm-hmm. ¿Qué más dimos?
¿Sí? ¿Qué es decir, para qué es esto?
Este botecito, si lo tienen, es para usar el tile, para que cuando acaben de poner todo lo que les gusten, se pone encima.
Es como glue.
Mosh posh, en inglés. So, tienen todos los materiales que pueden usar. Ustedes pueden ser creativos, usar la imaginación y crear lo que gustan. Pueden ser un títere, sí, claro. Sean creativos. Y todo esto fue posible por el Grant Early Learning with Families, ¿ok?
Gracias.
Muchas gracias. Vamos a darles un fuerte aplauso a ellos porque sí, nos ayudaron mucho, mucho, mucho.
Y ahora una cancioncita con
Josué.
Cuando pienso en Frida, Pienso en sandías y melodías. Pienso en sus perritos ladrando todo el día. ¡Uf! Cuando pienso en Frida Kahlo, pienso en chanquitos y caracolitos. Pienso en nopalitos y tortillas hechas a mano. Cuando pienso en Frida Kahlo, pienso en su arte, pienso en su vestimenta y pienso en su ceja. Cuando pienso en Frida, pienso en su accidente, pienso en su fortaleza, pienso en su tristeza. Cuando pienso en Frida, pienso en vivir mi vida muy plenamente, disfrutando de cada día como el día de los niños. Frida Kahlo. Conmigo.
Pleasure to have you. We hope you enjoyed our little show and just have a beautiful day.
Qué bonito día.
Y los vemos para la próxima.
Hasta luego. Thank you.